Hello everyone, how are you guys doing? How's everybody doing? YouTube land, this day, this evening, or this night, whatever time of the day it is that you are joining. So welcome back to the show. So I wanted to come on and talk to you guys about the season finale of the Kardashians on Hulu. And I wanted to come on because I just finished watching the episode. And you guys know I've been watching the entire season of this show. You guys asked me to watch it. I would suffer through it, but we made it through. And there is a lot to unpack in this episode. A lot. The crazy part about this is I feel like a lot of times I just have a lot of useless information. Like a lot of things live rent-free in my brain. And when I see someone lying about something, immediately wherever that image is stored in my brain, I know exactly where to go and find it. Okay? So we are coming here to talk about the Kardashians on Hulu season finale. So welcome. My name is April Butcher. If you're joining for the first time, I'm your mother on social, and I come to give you guys common sense commentary. This is not gossip. This is not hearsay. This is common sense commentary when it comes to things happening in pop culture, in the world, and in these internet streets. So if that interests you, definitely hit that subscribe button, like this video, and let's get into it. So I just came back from a work event, and that's why my makeup is still done and everything still did, girl. And I said, you know what, before I go to bed, let me watch this Hulu before I go to bed. Now I'm on Pacific Standard Time, so I guess they released the show on Eastern Standard Time midnight to count for Thursday, and then the rest of us just trickle on in. Okay, so I started watching the show, and of course they were leading up, you know, it was a cliffhanger last week about Tristan, which we're going to expose that crap, okay? And let me tell you, everything was showed up and showed out in this video. Now, I'm going to play some of the footage from the show, some of the key points and footage. I am not monetizing this video. You guys will be able to watch the rebroadcast with no commercials because I refuse to monetize this video, because it seems like on YouTube, when you monetize something, they come for you. They want to block your video. They want you to go through all these analytics and things. And I need people to see this. Okay? I need people to see this. So we are not monetizing anything over here. All right? So let's get into the mess. So we're going to start off with tonight. I never thought in a million years I would have caught the shade of this woman, allegedly, because she didn't say who she was mentioning, but I found the tea. And this woman is so vain, and I guess she has so much going on in her life that this just totally exposed them for who they were tonight. Okay? And I'm still trying to process everything because I'm like, you know what the Kardashians need for this show? I'm not lying. The Kardashians need a historian. They need a historian or someone to come in and direct this show, like really direct this show. Because if you're going to make us or not make us, you're going to try to make us believe. Okay? You're going to try to make us believe that all of this stuff tonight transpired in December for Christmas. You got us fooled. You got us thinking that we're crazy. And that threat she made tonight and the comment that she made to Courtney and the look that she gave Courtney solidified what I've been saying for weeks. What have you been saying, April? I've been saying that when Kim, Courtney, Chloe, and Chris stood up in Variety and did that video about you need to get up off your ass and work. Nobody works these days. Now, if you remember, Courtney was sitting in the front, Chloe was standing next to Kim, I believe, and Chris is on the other end. And the face that Chris gave when she said that, it to me reeked of tension in that family. I said it in my video that it had nothing to do with people outside. That's why it took her so many weeks to come out and acknowledge it. And she used the day after, it happened the day after Chris Rock and Will Smith had their altercation at the Oscars. So she conveniently picked or signed off for them to release this footage that day, where it would not be that much hoopla going on in the headlines for her. All the hoopla was directed towards Will and Chris. But I feel like it took her so long to come out and say, oh, I didn't mean it for these women, because she was directing it at her sister. And that's why I say all the time, there are days I wish I had a sister, but there's other days where I'm like, y'all could keep that mess, because if sisters is like this, hell, I don't need them. If your sister hating on you that bad, I don't need them, okay? This solidified to me tonight the amount of tea that I'm about to spill on you guys. What I need for you to do is, this is now going to be our little session. When it's late at night and I got insomnia and I done found something really deep, we are going to call this the nightcap. Okay, so when is this late, y'all see me pop on, grab your hot toddy, girl, sit down, get your cozy little blanket, put on your pretty little things robe, because this is not a Skims robe, put on your pretty little things robe, girl, and get ready and put your seatbelt on, because we about to break this crap down. Now, let me connect my phone, and there may be some lagging in my connection with my phone, because I notice at times it does that, it lags on my broadcast, so I apologize in advance. So we start off the show with Kim talking about Tristan and Chloe not answering the phone, and they need to have a family meeting. Now, I did not hear Chloe say not one time that they need to have a family meeting. I heard Chloe on that phone crying. She said, what? We need to have a family meeting. Okay, girl. Well, Chloe didn't show up to the family meeting. So who called that family meeting? Okay? Now let's get into the dirt, because the amount of threats that came out of this show tonight had me floored. Literally had me floored. And she almost got herself in a situation with bloggers, because we'll break that down in a little bit. So let's get into this. Let me pull up my phone. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the video for you guys, and then we'll break it down as the video is playing. So these are different clips from the show. Okay? Some of it is sped up vocally, because of course they're going to come for me. And some of it I have audio playing in the background, so excuse that too, girl. It is what it is. Now let's get into this video here, right now. Let me click this to start.
The lack of honesty is what does it for me. It's like, let's just be honest with who we are and what we're doing and the mistakes we're making, because it's way less hurtful to say the truth than to like find out on the internet and not feel like you're in the loop.
But it's such a lack of respect. This is somebody who's got a pattern of bad behavior, somebody that has lied to her since June.
To go through a whole declaration and to be deposed,
and to hire attorneys and go through all the last 6 months that he's had, 9 months.
You should have went to Chloe. As soon as there was information before a lawyer, you should have went to Chloe.
Now, I want to explain something to y'all. They sit down. You see Kim walk in the house. with this outfit on. I want to show y'all. Let me pull it up. She walks in the house, and I believe that they are at what's her face house, at our mom's house, okay? And she walks in with this outfit right here. This is not a photo from the show. This is a photo from another situation that was going down at our house at the same damn time. She was filming something else at our house that was simultaneously going on while she was recording this show. Okay? Now, and I'm going to be talking really slow because I want y'all to understand and I'm trying to gather my thoughts. Okay? I remember seeing this. I did not come onto YouTube doing full-time commentary until March, end of March. So at this time, you know, prior to March, February, January, I'm sitting around on the internet just like y'all. I'm sitting around and I'm consuming. There's a difference between being a consumer and being an influencer. So at that time, I was just being a consumer, consuming things at the same time you guys are consuming things. And one thing that I remember consuming during that time was the fact that Kim's cars caught my attention in this video right here. Kim got all of her cars painted all gray to match the outside of her house. And I remembered this video. When I initially saw Kim in this outfit on the show, okay, which is this outfit right here, and you see her show up to the house. Let me pull it back. You see her show up to the house in this outfit, mind the rings, okay, and she walks in.
Okay.
At that time, the minute I saw it, I thought that she was doing one of the giveaways at that time, because usually she does these giveaways, and I honestly believe she had did a giveaway picture at that time with all those Louis Vuitton bags, the Birkin, with all them bags they be having. It was a bunch of orange bags, so that way the cars would be green and the bags would be orange, and it would give that Hermes type of look, okay? Aesthetic. So I remember seeing this. So I initially went to her Instagram page to find that post, because I was like, I told my husband before he went to bed, I said, I've seen this before. I've seen her post something online with this before. So then when I went to the Instagram page, I couldn't find it. So then I went to YouTube and I looked it up, and there it was. And I want to show you guys. 3 months ago, Kim did Inside Kim's Home Filled with Wonderful Objects with Vogue. So they're trying to pass this on like this happened in December. And I could say, well, maybe Vogue released it 3 months ago and they filmed it in December. You guys know how the Kardashians roll. The Kardashians roll for Christmas like Christmas is Easter, okay? Like Christmas is Easter. They have the whole house decorated. There's lights. There's Christmas things going on. There's a whole bunch of caca going on in that house. From the looks of this video right here, I don't see no Christmas nothing on that table. I don't see no Christmas lights outside. I don't see no Christmas nothing. All the way down to the rings. Do you see the rings that are on her finger? These are the exact rings that she wore in this space when she was doing this video. The same exact rings. This is from the Vogue. Go look it up yourself. It's on YouTube. It was done 3 months ago, and she wore the same exact rings. Okay? Same exact dress, same exact makeup. So that right there out the gate had my ears up like a doggone, what you call that, Doberman pincher. I was like, okay, what in the hell is going on here? What kind of lies are y'all trying to tell us? Okay? Now it gets deeper. It gets deeper than that. Let's go back to the video and I'll show you guys what I mean by that. Let me get back to the video.
Honesty is what does it for me. Is like, what we're doing and the mistakes we're making, because it's way less hurtful to say the truth than to like find out on the internet and not feel like you're in the loop.
But it's such a lack of respect. This is somebody who's got a pattern of bad behavior, somebody that has lied to her since June.
To go through a whole declaration and to be deposed
and to hire attorneys and go through all the last 6 months trouble, that he's had, 9 months.
Did you hear? Let me make sure the echo's off. Did you guys hear what Chris said? She said the last 6 months, the last 9 months. And she mentioned the month June. So I was like, okay, girl, what type of games are y'all playing? Because at the beginning of the episode, they said that Tristan had gotten this girl pregnant in March 2021. So when they mentioned June, I'm like, oh, okay, this is probably when he signed the papers. Maybe when the girl was trying to sue him. And he went and did all his paperwork in June. So I start counting. I said July, August, September, October. If it's 9 months, right? July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March. March. March is 3 months ago. So March is 3 months ago. She wearing this outfit from 3 months ago that Vogue did. If you see here, 3 months ago, then where's the lie? The lies in the details of how this is being directed and filmed. Now, I'll tell you this. Listen very keen and very closely to what Courtney says, because Courtney low-key is exposing them at this table. Low-key exposing the whole entire operation. Now, once we get to the end, I'm going to give you my 2 cents on what actually I think is transpiring. Like I said, this is all alleged. This is just me being a consumer, just like the rest of you guys, being a damn snoop, just like the rest of you guys. Because one thing for me, 2 things for sure, you're not going to get my money. You're not going to get my money and be scamming me at the same damn time. It's not going to happen. So whenever I see someone selling a course online, when I see somebody selling clothes online, selling hair online, trying to get me to buy something, I go through it like a fine tooth comb. That's what mothers do, okay? Mother doesn't just mean you encompass being this grand boss, diva, whatever kind of term they try to make it out to be. Being a mother is being in control of your life. And for me, I will not allow anybody on social media to control my life, control my narrative. My goal here on this channel is to inform you guys so that way when you're purchasing things, you can make an informed decision. Okay? So this is common sense commentary. But pay attention to what Courtney says. Okay? And watch Kim threaten somebody. Let's get back to it.
She deserves it. Like, who gives a f- what other people think? I prefer to take the high road and be a good person. And who we are is we're people that would actually get Tristan help. That's who we are.
To say that I'm not tempted sometimes, I'd be lying. I'm exhausted of taking the high road. I mean, I'm on my zone where I'm like, if you bring bad energy in my life, like a boundary goes up. Half of me wants to just put it on blast. If you don't think I screenshot every single thing, that's my girl. I'm just not in the mood today, so I don't know. But, you know, I don't know.
Not in the mood.
And then I think.
All right. So let me show y'all what she meant by that and who she was possibly talking to. Because I'm going to speculate. I'm going to speculate. I said, now, is she talking to Kanye, talking about looking in the camera and saying, don't threaten me? Like, why would you even say that? Is Kanye an executive producer of the show? Does Kanye get to see the edits? Because why would you look in the camera and say you screenshot everything? And here goes Chris in the background co-signing. That's my girl. I said, I smell a snake. So then I go back and I type in and I look to find out where is this coming from? Who was she threatening during that time about getting screenshots and all this stuff? And she's not having it today. Well, look, lo and behold, 3 months ago, y'all see that right there in the corner? 3 months ago, the Kim, Kanye, Pete controversy on The Daily Show. So when all of this caca was going down 3 months ago, this had to have been filmed around the same time. Because if Vogue is saying 3 months ago, because Vogue had the capabilities to very much well come in, record, edit, and put up within a week. So if you're sitting here talking about you screenshot everything, who the hell you screenshotting? Larissa Pippen? Who the hell stuff you screenshotting? I said, oh, okay, 3 months ago. I come back here. Okay, I look it up again. 3 months ago, Kanye's rant. 3 months ago. So who is she threatening in that video? Is she threatening Kanye with capturing screenshots? She always taking the high road and she's tired of taking the high road. That's called life. That's called you put yourself in the spotlight. You wanted fame and this is the price of fame. Okay? We come here and I'm like, oh, okay, 3 months ago. So I'm like, okay, this isn't making any sense to me. Like, what kind of shenanigans does this woman have going on? You know? So let me go back to this video so you guys can hear the next part of caca that I saw.
Today, so I don't know. But, you know, I don't know. Not in the mood. And then I think, from the wise words of the great Michelle Obama, when they go low, you go high. All I want to know is if Khloé's going to make it to the photo shoot for Kardashian's show. Khloé thrives on being busy in these moments. Well, it's a distraction.
Did y'all just see how she looked at her? Did y'all just see how she looked at her sister? Because the narrative has always been, remember when they had that massive fight, Kourtney and Kim? The fight started because Kim was sitting on the floor and Kim told Kendall, y'all don't work as hard as we do. And Kendall said, what do you mean? Well, you don't work as hard as me and Khloé does. Me and Khloé always work and pick up the pieces. And you, she was talking to Kendall, you, Kylie, and she didn't say Kourtney yet. And Kourtney said, wait, what are y'all talking about? Okay. And she said, well, I was just saying that mom is always crying and me and Khloé are always picking up the pieces and doing all of the work. That's what started the fight. She told Kendall, you always have anxiety. Kylie always has something going on. Kourtney always got her thing going on. And me and Khloé have to pick up the slack. Well, where Kylie been this whole season? That's my question. I understand she's pregnant. But where she been the whole season? She went to the grocery store? She drove her car through the car wash? She stopped over the In-N-Out? We ain't never seen in Kylie's house. So Kylie getting the same amount as everybody else. If I was the rest of them, if I was Kendall, if I was Kourtney, I would be flipping tables. Because how in the natural hell, just because she the baby, she gets to get away with this caca? She didn't even show up to the finale. She did a voiceover. And she sounded like when she did the voiceover, like she was kind of smirking and laughing at him. Like, I got paid just like the rest of them, but I got to get off like a bandit. Okay? Who's to say Kylie didn't plan that pregnancy right around the time of this situation to happen? Who's to say she didn't set it up that way so she didn't have to film? That they would feel sorry and be like, okay, Kylie, just go lay down somewhere. I'm just being serious. Okay? Her and Stassi laying up in the damn house. while everybody else is working. I be flipping tables. Now, here's the real tea. I said, now this is 3 months ago. Well, when did she say you need to get up off your ass and work? When did she say that? I go and I pull it up from Variety, and that was 3 months ago. 3 months ago, she gave that advice. 3 months ago. So all of this is transpiring at the same time. And if you notice in the video I just showed you, what did I tell you guys? What did she say, actually? Courtney's sitting there saying, you know, well, first it started off with Kim saying, well, I'm just worried that, you know, Khloe is not going to make it to the Kardashians photo shoot for the show. If she just went through this horrible relationship breakup, then why the hell are you so pressed about her showing up to work? Don't we all get sick days? Don't we all get PTO? Because let me tell y'all, sisters, Courtney, Kendall, Kylie, y'all should be getting maternity leave. Y'all should be getting paid time off. Y'all should be getting sick leave. Y'all should write all of that in y'all damn contract. Y'all should get extended leave bank. Okay? Now, let me tell y'all something. She gave Courtney that look because Courtney then replied and said, well, Khloe is always, she said something to the effect of like a hard worker. Or she, you know, she doesn't disappoint or something like that. And Kim said, well, she's a hard worker or something like that. And then she gave Courtney a look because Courtney said, yeah, because she's dedicated or she have to. I don't know what the hell she just said. I'll replay it for y'all because I don't want to get to lying. All right. But she gave that woman a look. So let's get into Kendall next. Kendall is the next one up. Okay.
Kardashian's show. Khloe thrives on being busy in these moments. Well, it's a distraction.
Did y'all see their face?
Always doomsday. Everyone, all my friends make fun of me. I have this whole new room in my house that's all these crazy gadgets and gizmos.
Were you by yourself?
There's so.
But I'm fine. I've been put on some beta blockers, and I'm gonna block all this shit out of my system, and everyone can off.
Trolls on the internet that make Khloe feel like the biggest piece of shit. I will find each and every one of you, and not threaten you on TV. But it's wrong. Like, it's so wrong, because you guys don't understand that when you have a child, you'll do anything to try to make it work. And I'm so proud of who Khloe is, that she wanted to give her relationship a second chance, even after he dogged her and embarrassed the shit out of her. When the whole world is looking at you, laughing at you, calling you every name in the book, do you know how hard that is? That is 10 times harder to stay in a situation than it is to leave.
I mean, Kim found a guy who's...
Y'all hear that bull crap? Do y'all hear that bull crap? Now let me tell y'all why this girl possibly fainted. Let me tell y'all why this girl possibly fainted. Now first, let's get to Kendall. Now let me tell y'all something about Kendall. Ooh, child, Kendall, let me be your best friend so I can come over to your house and play in all them gadgets. Because one thing about April Butcher, I got tons of gadgets in my house. I got a sauna blanket. I got tons of Fareo devices. I have a microdermabrasion device. I got, what do you call it, microcurrent. I got all them damn gadgets. When I saw Kendall jump out that hyperbaric chamber, honey, I was like, give me a hyperbaric chamber. I want to be Michael Jackson and live. Well, he didn't live forever, God forgive me. But I want a hyperbaric chamber. Okay? That's the real tea. I found that out in Columbia. Hyperbaric chambers are the tea. Okay? She know what she doing with that hyperbaric chamber, honey. But when Chloe told her that she fainted, okay? When Chloe told her that she fainted, I said to myself, what the hell you faint for, sis? When that girl said she taking beta blockers, because if y'all didn't see the earlier this season, when they went to Saturday Night Live for New York, in New York, y'all have to remember, Chloe did a small role on Saturday Night Live when they did the People's Court, when Kim was playing Courtney on the stand as the judge. Chloe could barely say her lines. She had such anxiety. Then she had to go do a couple more shows. Ellen, she had to, you know, they little best friends. Ellen, and then that other little Corbin, whatever his name is. She had to go do all them shows. The girl suffers from crippling anxiety. I do not dispute that. To the point, this girl done mentioned beta blocker several times on this goddamn show. And it fears me, because what if all these kids around the world are going to start taking beta blockers for anxiety, taking their grandmother's beta blockers, their mama's beta blockers? Didn't we see this on Euphoria? When Euphoria first started, the girl was going in there with her daddy that had cancer and taking his medicine. That's how this stuff starts. They see somebody like that online, and then they go and they take stuff like that. They should be mindful. Now, let me show you why the girl possibly is fainting. You go and you look up with beta blockers, the side effects. Look at the side effects, you guys. Feeling tired, dizzy, or lightheaded. This could be signs of a slow heart rate. Cold fingers or toes. Difficulty sleeping or nightmares. And feeling sick. Google told me that. You so busy trying to cure the anxiety that you're damn near killing yourself. That ish is there to slow down your heart rate. So you wonder why you're fainting? You wonder why you're dizzy? Like, that's not something to laugh about. It's not something to laugh about. And it's definitely not something to be sharing on social media. You could, or on TV, you could easily say, oh, I'm gonna take my anxiety medicine. People don't have to know what it is that you take. Okay? So stop playing with us. And stop playing with these impressionable children and people that are watching your show thinking that they need to be on beta blockers for anxiety. When my doctor will not just prescribe anything for me. He wants me to use natural things. So when I was having anxiety going to a job that I used to have, he prescribed folate. Folate is like folic acid. It's better than folic acid. You have to take folate. He told me just take one folate pill a day, and that'll ease the anxiety. So vitamin. So why are you sitting up here pushing beta blocker drugs? Next thing you know, we're going to see Chloe on a commercial at 10 o'clock in the morning in between The Price is Right and The Young and the Restless talking about beta blockers. Stop playing with us, okay? Now we're going to go to this next scene with her and freaking Scott, Lord. Scott's still dangling around, still hanging around, still being around, okay? So let me pull this up. Oh, and one more thing before I pull that up. She was really getting ready to threaten every single blogger known to man. She tried to say trolls. They make sure they say trolls, okay? Trolls ain't worried about y'all. Trolls ain't writing up no stories about the Kardashians. You know what trolls are doing? Coming in the comment section of our videos and taking down our channels and attacking our channels like crazy when we're doing live streams. That's what they do, okay? That's what they do. They are on the bridge. Think about a bridge and think about where a troll hangs out, right? You're trying to cross over to the bridge. The bridge is the other side. So if I have my audience on this side and I'm on this side of the bridge and they're trying to cross over to gather the information, that troll comes in between that connective information. That's why you see trolls come in these videos and take the living F over. So don't come with oh, these internet trolls. You really want to say these internet bloggers. Let's keep it 1,000% correct. Now, one thing I will not come on my channel and do that I see other people do that I will not do, I'm not going to degrade them by talking about their looks, like talking about them to the point it is degrading. You're calling them out of their names. You call them all kind of weird names, all kind of nicknames. I don't have to do none of that to prove my point. Proving my point is pulling the facts, pulling receipts. That's where we keep it Gucci, okay? Now, they won't mess with me. They might try to mess with me, but let me make you understand one thing about me that they can't mess with. If they come and mess with me, I'm going to tell the judge, tell whoever in that courtroom, go pull the timeline of when this stuff was filmed and tell me if I'm lying. Because I don't see no Christmas lights outside, not the way they dress. I don't see nothing Christmassy outside. I don't see no Christmas lights. I don't see a Christmas tree in Scott house or Kim house. When Vogue came to film in her house, I did not see not near Christmas tree or lights. She always have Christmas tree and lights up in her house. So let's keep it correct and let's keep it 100%. Okay? Now, she sat up there and threatened everybody, damn near, allegedly, almost. And she caught herself. She said, oh, I'm not going to threaten. Yeah, you were getting ready to. You're getting ready to threaten every blogger. Because let me make you understand something. Kim is used to life when she first started her show and everybody just being so nice and everybody taking pictures of her bandage dresses and want to do their eyeshadow like her. Y'all got to remember, there was an era on YouTube back when Kim first came out that there were thousands of girls on YouTube trying to do the Kim Kardashian curls. Go look them up. How to do Kim Kardashian curls. Type it in the search engine of YouTube and see how many videos of girls trying to show you how to do their hair like Kim, do their eyes like Kim. This is a new day and age. People are wise enough to y'all games. People are wise enough to your spells, Maleficent. Okay? Now, when she did that, I said, okay, first you threatened allegedly Kanye, because that all was going on at the same time. And then you turn around and you almost threaten every blogger. And then you want to tell us we're supposed to feel sorry for Khloé because Khloé went back to a man after he after he kissed or had your sister's best friend on his lap at a party. You kicked the sister best friend out, Jordan, but you still took him back. And you take him back again. And she has taken him back again since this situation. And I got the receipts to prove that ish too. Okay? Now, let's go on over to Scott. Let's see what Scott talking about with his little sad self. Okay?
Whole world is looking at you, laughing at you, calling you every name in the book. Do you know how hard that is? That is 10 times harder to stay in a situation than it is to leave.
I mean, Kim found a guy who's a great guy. He's so sweet.
Like, yeah, he's so much. Sweet.
Like, picked us up from the airport the other day, like, had her, the coffee she wanted, had a coffee for me. I didn't want to tell him it was completely wrong one. He's just a great person.
That's so nice.
And, like, you can tell he cares about people's feelings. He was supposed to come over here, actually. I don't know where he is.
Oh my gosh, are you and Pete besties?
Mm-hmm.
Oh gosh.
Bunk beds, whole thing.
Oh my god.
We have the best time together.
I'm happy but that she's nice someone that's nice to her, right. Like caters to her.
Yeah. Think she hasn't had that in a really long time.
No, but it's also just he makes her laugh. I like everyone.
No, it's really
that.
Cute. She's so different too in front of him. She like says like slang, like young slang words.
Oh my
like
god.
She's like, yo, like you. I'm like, what?
Oh my god.
Pete is so sweet. I don't know him really, really well, but from what I do know, I think it's really drama-free. It's really easy. And I think that's something that's the end goal. Everyone wants that fairy tale. Everyone wants the happily ever after.
Had this guy come in who plays piano and sax.
Everybody want this fairy tale? Everybody want this fairy tale. But y'all couldn't give Courtney a whole show to herself that actually has a real fairy tale with somebody that is engaged to her that she actually was going to marry. Scott could sit up there and be happy for Kim, but he can't be happy for his baby mama. The other thing I don't like that they're doing right now, they're trying to make Pete sound like he's this glorified somebody, right? Pete is awesome. Pete is great. Pete is this and Pete is that. Peter Piper, Peter Pecker Eater, okay? You talking about he showed up to the airport, he picked y'all up, he got y'all coffee. The coffee wasn't the one that you really wanted. Is he y'all chauffeur? Or is he dating Kim? Why is he picking y'all up from the airport? Where is your driver? Where is your driver? Mr. Let the Lord be with you. Then he's going to get in his phone and say, oh yeah, me and Pete are best friends. Yeah, bunk beds, everything. Yeah, he's supposed to be here right now. How he's supposed to be there right now? Now remember, I just showed y'all what happened 3 months ago, right? Now she's meeting with Pete. Let me show y'all this receipt over here. Let me see if I can pull this up. 2 months ago, Pete Davidson and Northwest jar riding, hanging with the Kardashian family. So was this the time that Pete was supposed to show up to your house, Scott? Was this what he was showing up to your house for? Was he supposed to show up and be bamboozled by the cameras? And then the cameras didn't get him? Did the cameras catch him on the way out of your driveway and they snapped that picture of him and gave it to TMZ? Because TMZ is not allowed beyond that gate. I know exactly where that gate is. I know exactly where the gate is. When y'all saw tonight, if you watched the live broadcast and you saw Chloe driving to Malibu, I've been on that road going back to Malibu from Calabasas. I'm very familiar with the area. You cannot cross that fence. So did the camera crew leave your house allegedly and then snap the picture of Pete and the video of Pete and then send it to TMZ so they could have it? What actually happened? I'm confused. And then Chloe sits there and says, oh, well, I don't really know Pete, but I think he's, I don't really know no Pete, but I think he's really good for my sister. How is Scott best friends with Pete, but you don't really know no Pete? How's that? How that work? Make me understand that. How does that work? Now, in my mind right now, what I'm thinking too, what is ringing in my mind right now, when Kim said that threatening message to the camera, which I'm alleging she was sending that to Kanye, I bet you anything she looked in that camera and then she told that cameraman, send that video to Kanye and let him know we're filming right now. And if he messes with me anymore, I'm going to use this. Okay? Don't be surprised, honey. Do not be surprised. Okay? So let's get into the next part of the video. Now, what I am loving is I'm loving the fact that Courtney and her mom are mending their relationship. That's one thing for sure, because Courtney and Chris did not have a great relationship on the Keeping Up with the Kardashians. But on the Kardashians, you could tell they've been going to therapy and working on themselves. And I'm here for that. My thing is, I'm not here to just tear them down and find out and just tear them down on their looks and tear them down here without any facts. I do also give credit where credit's due. And I do have to say, her working on her relationship with her mom is a great thing. And I'm here for it. Okay? Now, let's get back into this video.
After.
Had this guy come in who plays piano and sax?
But the production.
That was so good. Thank you, Trev.
I am packing up some of Tristan's clothes. Then bad happens. I just become more of a recluse and I just need alone time. I have people in my face all the time. Whether it be construction or crews or whatever, you don't, I need just the time.
I'm not that Chloe's here today.
Hey, Chloe, can I talk to you by side?
She's such a professional, but she must be like dying inside.
I know how to do it.
Yeah,
he finally was like, you know what, I gotta go to therapy, I gotta look within myself, I gotta start fixing myself, and then you do, and it's like too late. That's just like sad, you know?
Yeah, it is sad. I'm like, wow, you really just like up your life.
And he's still doing the same things, knowing like, if that were me and I was really trying to like redeem myself and I was trying to be a better person, I would definitely just keep my dick in my pants.
You ready? Yep. I'm gonna do one more right after this.
You see the caca? Do you see the caca? Now let me tell you what just transpired right there. You see Chloe saying, I packed up all of Tristan's things, I'm putting them out the house. At one point in the show, I didn't record, put this clip in there. But at one point in the show, she's in her bed and she's like, Tristan wanted to go half on the house with her. Half on the down payment. That was the word she said, not the house. So is the house paid cash or are you paying a note on it? Because she said, Tristan wanted to go half on the down payment. And I told him, no, this is my house. I want this to be my house. Okay, sis, do you. You see her packing up in the closet. And what did she tell the camera crew? I have too many people in my face. I have the construction people in my face, the crew in my face, and sometimes I just need a break. So why can Kylie be gone from the show pretty much the whole entire season? Kendall only show up for maybe 5 to 10 minutes every episode, if that. Courtney over there with Travis doing their own thing, honey. I'm here for it. But Chloe can't take a minute to herself because Chloe is the storyline this season. Pete won't come on there. I guarantee you, if Pete has signed a contract to be on that show, guess what? Pete would be on that show and we wouldn't even be hearing about Chloe and Tristan. Trust and believe. Because my thing is, if this hurt Chloe so freaking bad, then why are we rehashing this for her? Why are we putting her through anxiety yet again? I honestly believe that Chloe deals from crippling anxiety. Y'all have to understand there was a time when Chloe was the fan favorite. Chloe was overweight. Chloe was over there being a little wife to Lamar. She had a dark hair. She actually has blonde hair that she would dye dark to try to fit in with her sisters. She was always the real one. And over time, look at the show she created, Revenge Body, to get back at people, to get back at the public for judging all that time. So I understand that there are traumas there for her. I understand that completely and solely I understand that. I shared a story with you guys today about my daughter getting her hair relaxed at such a young age. And then most people will be like, well, she doesn't remember her hair being relaxed at one. But you have to understand, we had to cut all of her hair off over time for the period of 5 years to get the bad burnt hair off of her head. So it was a process for her, and she is still traumatized by that. So I understand people deal with traumas. But if you see, they're at that shoot. She shows up for the shoot for the show. And Kim takes her aside and takes her in the room because I've bet you anything, Chloe was getting that itch to quit filming. And without Chloe, she don't have a show. Kim does not have a show. So could it be she went and she brought Chloe aside to ring her back in? Y'all have to understand, these are how people that can be abusive to your mental health, that can be toxic, let me not use the word abusive, but can be very much toxic to your mental health, that will not allow you to get the rest, get the time. Because she could have fainted and have a serious heart situation. We see Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber got some kind of issue going on. Hailey Bieber just had a stroke. A stroke in her 20s, y'all. That is major, okay? Now, the stroke that Hailey Bieber had, we have to remember she had a heart condition that was undiagnosed, a birth defect. But at the end of the day, these young people are getting sick so fast with major health issues. She needs to take some rest. They said they was going to quit keeping up with the Kardashians, and they came right back a year later with this show. 18 years on one station and now you on this one? Go lay down somewhere. Because at this point, Khloé's major complaint, and the reason why Kim was saying, oh, you trolls, better leave her alone, when it stops subjugating her to be exposed to the public and for the public to even care about her and Tristan. That's her choices. We've seen Khloé do this time and time again with Lamar. She covered up for Lamar for years. So you think we see anything different in Tristan? That's something that Khloé has to work on for herself. It's something that a lot of us have to work on for ourselves. I had to learn that about friendships. Why do I keep having friends that take advantage of me? And once they get all the information, or they get the hookup, or they get the plug, not the plug, they get the connect, okay? They get rid of the plug, because now they got a direct connect with the connect, okay? So they don't need you no more. Why is that happening? Well, April, you need to look at yourself and you need to stop sharing every ounce of information with people. That's how you solve that problem. Now I've been living a stress-free life. Maybe Khloé needs to disconnect from this show and live her freaking life. Okay? Now, after all of that, they came with the season finale, child. The little ending. Y'all know how they do the little endings, child. So they do the little endings and everybody, you see, like Courtney's talking and Courtney's saying she want her life. Now, this one here, she don't even show up. They just show clips of her. Her little highlights from the show. She was only on 3 episodes. Now, at the ending of this, here go Chris.
Well, I would love to with a camera.
To be continued, what? We don't want nothing else. Y'all leave us alone. Go do something. You got one daughter with crippling anxiety. You got another daughter just had a baby. Okay? She got 2 kids. She got a baby daddy. We don't know what's going to happen to him and his brand. And all the people that done had severe situations at Astroworld, for lack of a better term. You got Khloé over there, crippling anxiety. You got Kendall is a schizophrenic, I don't know what, not schizophrenic child. Let me take that back. Let me retract that. She's not a schizophrenic child, but she's a hypochondriac. That's the word I was looking for, with medical devices. You got Kim over here that's just trying to keep this going. And what that tells me is that she feels that she can't thrive and sell product without this show. You have to understand something. Kim has 300 and something million followers on Instagram. Okay? A lot of them followers that she got is men. A lot of them followers she got is bots. There's only, I would say, out of all of them followers that Kim has, Kim maybe has a strong million women that will buy whatever she's selling. Okay? That's just my opinion and I'm going to stick to it. Now, here's the real tea. So, y'all remember a couple weeks ago, they went to Italy for Courtney's wedding. And Khloé didn't bring True. She left True here in the States. She went to Italy with her family, right? Okay. Tristan stayed at home. I looked at that background. I said, that looked familiar. That looks very familiar. Okay. Now, from this episode, Khloé's supposed to be so heartbroken, so devastated. Then if you so devastated, sis, then why is he in your kitchen? Why is he in your kitchen, sis? Why is he in your kitchen? That is the same freaking kitchen, the same little board, exactly the same knobs, exactly the same everything. This was 3 weeks ago. If I am done with you, dating you, I am done with you. If you want to watch my daughter, then you take my daughter to your house. Okay? You don't get to take my daughter, sit in my house and do whatever you want. This is a man that you are promoting online that he is such a dog, in Kim's words, not mine. He's such a horrible person. He can't be trusted. This man is worth $45 million, by the way, so he far from broke. So don't think he hanging around because he broke. His estimated net worth is $45 million. Okay? You say he all of those things, but you got him in your house. Now, some people would argue and say, you know what? She was gone for a week. Maybe she wants True in her own environment so True could play with her own toys. But if True has a relationship with her daddy, as strong as y'all been messing around and things like that, right? Okay? Then she should have her own setup at her daddy house. That shouldn't have nothing to do with anything if you gone for a week. Okay? I'm just saying, all of this crap be a bunch of lies. A house of cards, okay? That is her kitchen. That's her kitchen. But y'all not together no more. Okay? Y'all not together no more. He's smiling. He playing in your house. Let me tell you why I wouldn't let him in my house. He would have to take her to his house. Let me tell you why. Because if he out here doing all of this craziness with all these different women, then I'd be damned. I find out this man done brought somebody in my house while I'm gone. If he been doing all of this type of crazy behavior, maybe he trying to do this to get out of the family. I don't know. Because remember on one of the episodes, the one where Kanye showed up, because Kanye did show up for a couple episodes. When Kanye did show up, remember? I think Trisha said, Chloe said something to the effect, and I'm going to paraphrase. She said something to the effect of, oh yeah, our family is like the mafia. And Trisha said something to the effect of like, yeah, blood in, blood out. And she said, yeah, never cross the family. Are you kidding me right now? And this is the same Tristan that on that episode that Kim was saying she wants a man that can work out with her. It's all about the little things, okay? It's all about the little things. You know, she wants somebody like Tristan. She's been a third wheel working out with them every morning. So what? Kanye don't want to work out. What else is new? You know, they try to make it seem like, oh, there's no drama anymore in Kim's life. That's what they call Kanye. And that's, I don't like when people say that. I don't like when people say, oh, girl, you just be full of drama. What you talking about? Your whole life is a drama series on Hulu. So how the hell you can say I'm full of drama? Every 5 minutes, everybody making a damn video about you and your family lying about what y'all doing. So to me, you the drama, not me. So that's why Kanye be freaking losing it like he be losing it. Because now you giving them names, and you giving names to a person that made y'all career. Yeah, she did that little Ray J CD, DVD, VHS tape, whatever the hell it was, okay? On that ancient-ass computer that Kanye brought to her. The fact of the matter is, Kim was never on that level until she got with this man, and this man elevated the whole entire family. So for Scott to sit there and be like, oh yeah, you know, Pete is less drama. You got Chloe over here. Oh yeah, Gemini's are so full of drama. Well, you know what? Quiet as is kept. Okay? Let's look it up. What's today? Yesterday was the 15th. Let's look it up. Because I was telling Brian this tonight. Let's see what this is. Well, y'all think y'all got rid of Kanye, But North's birthday was yesterday, and North is a Gemini. So what y'all gonna do to her when she start having her own mind? Cause she 9 now. What y'all gonna do when she start having her own mind? Cause the difference between a Kanye West and his kids, he was raised from humble beginnings with not much money. He had to learn what a work ethic is and what hard work is. These kids have an indisposable amount of money at their disposal whenever they want it. So to make reference to Kanye as drama and to make reference to Kanye as, oh, he's a Gemini and I told you about Geminis and they crazy and they this and they that. I have my comments also from my personal experiences with different zodiacs and how I am as a zodiac. But for you to say that on national TV about a child's dad, and then that child is under that same zodiac, y'all not right and y'all not good. That's just my opinion. What y'all gonna do to her? She gonna give y'all a run for y'all money. I know that much. I know that much. Geminis give you a run for your money, honey. Okay? Don't play. But for me, I felt that this whole entire episode really exposed them for what they are. And I feel like if you're going to do all of this extracurricular things and making up these fake storylines and doing all this kind of crazy stuff, then at the end of the day, at the end of the day, you either suck it up with the negative press coming at you, or you get up off of the internet and off of our internet streets, because we don't want you. We don't. So it is in the internet streets. It's, I tell people all the time, remember, I don't have it up back here. I'm the master of the internet streets. I know how these streets run. I know how difficult it could be in these streets. I know how people talk about you and say things about you. I know how people come and steal your intellectual property and then try to act like they came up with the idea. I know all of that about these internet streets. But you can either make the choice to keep running in it, mastering it, working on the streets the way you need to work, working every block. When I tell y'all the blocks are just like a regular street. You got a Walmart on this block, a Target on that block. You got Twitter. You got Facebook, you got YouTube, you got Snapchat, you got TikTok, you got Instagram, you got WhatsApp. You pick your poison of where you want to play on the internet streets. The internet streets would afford you a lot of money that you can make here. But at the same time, it comes with a price. She gets in all three of them goddamn cars that I showed y'all. This woman got three damn cars. She got a Maybach. She got a Rolls Royce. She got a Lamborghini. Okay, you got three damn cars. You took all three of them and painted every ounce of the car, including the rims, gray. Every one of them. So you remember when you get in your driver's seat to drive your nice Maybach that you love so much. Okay? You remember that. When you get negative tweets and negative comments. Because if you're so booked and busy, here's another thing. If Kim and Khloe is so booked and busy, then what they doing on the internet? Do y'all get sleep? Kim got four children. What you doing on the internet snooping and perusing around with what they call that? Fakesters? Fake Instagrams? Finsters? That's what they call them? What you running around with Finsters for? If you so booked and busy, if you telling us to get up off our ass and work, then what kind of work are you doing that y'all got time to worry about what the internet is saying about y'all? It don't make no sense. And then the killing part about the show, the way the show ended with Chris saying, oh, you wouldn't believe what's going on in my family right now. And the camera lady says, well, show us. We'd like to see it with the camera. And she just, and then it says to be continued. I felt like on the end of Twilight Breaking Dawn 1. Y'all remember at the end of Twilight Breaking Dawn 1 when Bella's body was changing to a vampire, and at the very end, they zoom in on our eyes and our eyes just open up like that, I literally felt like I was in Twilight. Like, oh my God, we have to relive this again. We have to go to a part two of this. Oh my God. It is what it is. I can't sit on YouTube and make money and then gripe and complain every 5 minutes about something that the platform is doing. Oh, the comments are down. Oh, this went down. Oh, YouTube doesn't have a live person to answer the phone lines. You know why? Because their money goes into servers. IBM servers that, as I'm live right now, it's allowed me to broadcast not just in the U.S., but the world. There are people right now in this broadcast is from South America, from the U.K., from all over the world, Australia. Every single day they come in these broadcasts and listen and enlighten their minds and make clear choices and decisions on what they want to do. Just yesterday or day before yesterday, whenever we did the live about the Yeezys, there were over 20 comments in the comment section saying that people went and purchased Yeezys just off the fact that we talked about them and showed them and explained to people that Yeezys don't cost $1,000. They actually cost $220. This is about informing people, not just sitting around talking about gossip every day. There are days I come on here and I want to kiki, 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 kiki. And there are other days when I want to come on here and I want to be real and show what is actually going on and how they're trying to fool us and market to us to be a bunch of cows going through, or a bunch of yaks like Jeffree Star going and grazing through the damn pasture. What's up from Canada? UK is in the house. There are people from all over the world, and YouTube has to pay for those servers. YouTube has to pay for the buildings that those servers sit in. When there are things that go down with the servers, they have to pay people to take care of that type of ish. So you can't sit here and gripe and complain on a free platform where some of your favorite influencers, I could name them right now. There are some of them that are making $18,000. $30,000. I've seen somebody's actual AdSense and it was $16,000. And that was just the middle of the goddamn month. I'm nowhere near close that. I'm not even scratching at that. There are a lot of them that come on here and make that type of money every day. My goal here is to inform you guys. Help you guys save money. Help you spend your money where you need to spend it at, and how not to be fooled by these shows. How not to have your heartstrings triggered because you feel like, oh, I'm like Chloe. Chloe's over here dealing with this man that keeps just doing her wrong over and over again. I just love her. Oh, I'm like Kim. I'm dealing with this crazy baby daddy that just be driving me crazy. No, that baby daddy of hers allowed them to stay in the multi-million dollar mansions that they're in right now. I'm pretty sure at some part they would have gotten, some point they would have gotten to where they at, but it would have took a lot longer and they probably wouldn't have as much clout as they have currently right now. So let's keep that same energy. With that being said, I just want to come on and enlighten you guys, because there are going to be 1,001 videos being posted today of the season finale of the Kardashians. See, they don't even call it the Kardashians. Keeping Up with the Kardashians season finale. They're going to report to you like they watched the show. They're going to get second, third hand information from every which way. My goal is to come on and debunk what I just saw, because it really pissed me the hell off how they tried to play us and make us believe that because Chris was sitting up there on this show this season, that was the other thing she did during the show. She created a Christmas carol. Her, Travis, and Courtney were in the studio and made a Christmas carol with Corey. And the Christmas song went out. So we supposed to believe that was done around Christmas? Stop playing with us. Like, we're not idiots. I hate when companies and brands and influencers think that we are so dumb. Like, the general public is just so dumb. And we don't know anything. We don't see anything. And they could just take our money whenever they feel like it. No, The amount of money that people spend in Skims, the amount of money that people spend with her brand, with Good American, they should take that money and buy seeds. Grow you some fruit. Grow you some vegetables. Do something else with your money. Enjoy your life. Because at this point, we all not promised tomorrow. So you may as well live your life till the wheels fall off. Okay? With that being said, I just want to come on, break down the highlights of the show, talk about her alleged threat to Kanye. I'm going to say that. Because she ain't say his name, but them receipts sure the hell show up. And if you guys see anybody, anyone in their broadcast use this screenshot, use this other screenshot back here where it actually has the months and the dates on it, y'all let me know. Y'all come up in my comment section and in my DMs, and y'all let me know that people is using my ish so I can start cracking down on that ish too. Because I'm about to start being like Monique up in this bitch. Excuse my French. I'm really fed up at this point with the people that come on my channel, watch my stuff, and then go back and copy it. So I'm just going to start calling people out. I'm going to call them out by name because I've about had enough at this point. So if you see those links show up, if you see any clips of my videos and they're not giving me credit, don't even bother going in their comment section. Come over to my comment section, alert me of what's going on, and I'll handle it the best way I can. Facts. Now, with that being said, I hope you guys learned something. I'm just going to comb through the comment section because I know some people like to read all the comments during their videos, but what I like to do is come back and visit the videos because if I'm on a topic, I'm on a subject, and I have a train of thought, I want to make sure I complete that train of thought so I make sure that I'm educating you guys on everything. Okay? So Shea Love said, the fact that she's selling a BS skincare line for $600 just shows you it's all money grab. And they don't care about what the realities of what people are going through. That's facts. Okay? Now, I can easily, and I've been saying I was going to do this because you guys are always asking me about my makeup. You're always asking me about my skincare, especially when I do my car chats. What am I using on my skin? What am I doing on my skin? I really need to sit down this weekend and create some content for you guys. Not long videos, honey, but short-term content, or short-form content is the word I'm looking for, that will allow you guys to see all the gadgets, all the things that I'm using, so you don't get bamboozled into thinking that you have to buy that whole entire line. Okay? If you want to buy it, you buy it. It's your own informed decision. But if you're looking for something more alternative, I could provide that also. And also, me and Brian are working on a couple things for you guys because I know y'all like seeing Brian come on my channel. We're working on a couple things for you guys where it will be more interactive and allow us to connect on a deeper level. And it won't have to do with you guys coming here to Vegas. This is going to be something we could do once a week as a family because I think it needs to be done. So we will be working on that and rolling that out come this week. I'm looking at more comments. Somebody said Lamar and Rob was in love. I can't with you, Jennifer. Jennifer, you are a mess. Y'all don't be fighting in the comment section, y'all. Y'all don't be fussing at each other in the comment section. Oh, man. Yeah, I couldn't believe that they were threatening, that she tried to call herself threatening bloggers. The easy solution to that is get Chloe off the show. Let Chloe take a hiatus, a break, like a real break. Let her take a break. Now, let me tell you something about that Neutrogena All. I have a video on my Instagram where I show you, you mix the Neutrogena All with this other soap by Bioderm, and you will clean your makeup brushes for filth. Like, every ounce of dirt will come out. If you ever clean your makeup brushes and it seems like when you go to rinse them out, they're still suds, and they're still suds, and they're still suds, I have a solution for you. I also have a solution for you guys that, like, if you have makeup that is very hard to shake up and get it to shake real good, I have a solution for that also. So just follow me on Instagram. My name on Instagram is April Butcher. Follow me on Instagram, and that's why I'll be dropping all the tips of how you guys can learn all of these things. Okay? Aw, you want me to do my little jingle? Exactly, exactly, Sandra. Exactly. I'm too tired to do my jingle, Esther. Okay? But what I will say, okay, tonight, and what Jennifer said, because y'all crying laughing at Jennifer. What Jennifer said? Thank you, Shay Love, for the super chat, girlfriend. I love you. I love you so much. Okay? All right? I can't. Jennifer is crazy. Okay? But with that being said, you guys, you have a blessed day, evening, or night, whatever time of the day it is that you're watching. Remember to control that pet population. Have your pet spayed or neutered. And I will see you guys in the next broadcast. Talk to you guys later. Bye.